Hello dear friends, welcome back once again to our channel Vage Academy of Mathematics, and we are here to solve the question paper of 2017 November UGC NET paper 1, and as usual from the concepts of arithmetic and reasoning. So this session we just have only one question. Let's quickly get into the question. Yeah, we go. So our question is from directions. This question is from the concept of directions. Already in directions we have solved many questions in our previous sessions, so here we are getting one such question. Let's see what is given in the question. So yes, a postman walked 20 meters straight from his office, then he turned right and walked 10 meters, then after turning to his left he walked 10 meters, and after turning right he walked 20 meters. He again turned right and walked 70 meters. Yeah, that's all. And finally our question is how far he is from his office. So we have seen this kind of questions, many questions we have seen in our previous sessions. So yes, as usual, let's start. Let's just take that the postman is starting from this particular point. We'll randomly mark it here. Yes, let's say the postman is starting from this particular point. Yes, now we go on. So from here the postman is walking 20 meters straight from his office. That's the first information given to us. So 20 meters straight, so let's have the 20 meters straight to be something like this. 20 meters straight. Yes, fine. So this would be 20 meters straight, and let's see, continue the question. Then he turned right and walked 10 meters. So yeah, from here he is turning right and he is walking 10 meters. So let's have the 10 meters to be something like this. This would make sense. Yeah, this would be 10 meters. He turned right and then he walked 10 meters. So turned right in the sense, so previously he was traveling in this direction. Now when he is going to take his right, it will be like this. So this way he is going to make 10 meters. Let's note it. Then after turning left, he again walked for 10 meters. So that's the third information given to us. So from this point, he's going to turn left. So left for this person would be like this. Is it or not? Yeah, it's again going to be 10 meters. So let's continue and let's mark 10 meters here also. Yeah, it's going to be 10 again. And after turning right, he walked 20 meters. So he is now here. From this point, he is going to take a right. So right in the sense, it will be like this. Is it or not? So this would be once again 20 meters they have given here. So let's note the 20 meters here. Yeah, it would be 20 meters. So let's follow the directions clearly. He started from this point. He just directed this way. Then he took a right this way. Then he took a right left. Left will be like this. And once again here, he took a right. So that will be this way. And then finally what is given, let's see, he again turned right. So that means from this point he is going to turn right and he walked 70 meters. So that means it will be something like this, right? Yeah, he should come down towards the down. So this would be actually, yeah, let's carefully note it. Let's see that we are getting a straight line. Yes, yes, we are getting it. 70 meters. So we should draw the lines with a sense what distance it is given to us, right? So in the same sense, if we draw, it would look logical. That's the reason. So yeah, he is taking a right here. So right in the sense, it will be like this direction, and he is walking for 70 meters. So finally he is reaching his destination. So this point is going to be his destination, and the question is asking for how far he is from his office. So this is the question. So that means we need to find the distance, this distance, that means the starting point to his destination. So let's try to connect these two points using a dotted line like this. Yeah, fine, we have connected. So now we need to find the distance between the starting point and this destination. So definitely we would need the help of Pythagoras theorem. So we have already used Pythagoras theorem. So whenever we have a right angle triangle, we use the Pythagoras theorem. And for the, just to remind it, Pythagoras theorem is nothing but c square is equal to a square plus b square, where that c is going to be the, it's going to be the longest side of the right angle triangle. Is it or not? We have already seen this formula. We have also used it So the same thing is what here also we are going to use it, because here again we can construct a right angle triangle like this. Now to make the task very easy, we'll just name it like this. We'll have the starting point to be A, and we'll have this point to be B, and we'll have this ending point to be C. So that means this AC distance is what we need to find, right? Because AC is what is the distance between the starting point and the ending point. So here we are able to form a right angle triangle, and this AC distance is what is asked in the question. Fine. So to answer this, we definitely need the distances AB. This AB we need, actually this AB. This AB distance we need. Just a minute. Yeah. Fine. Yeah. This AB distance, this we need. And also BC's distance, this also we need. So when we have these two distance values, we can very easily get the answer. But how can we get the values of AB and BC? It's going to be very easy. First of all, think about AB. How can we calculate this AB value? AB will be nothing but, see here, with the parallel property, this distance is what is going to be AB. Is it or not? The arrow mark which is drawn at the top, that corresponds to distance AB. See here that AB will be nothing but, here horizontally there's a distance of 10. So this 10 plus this 20. So that means 10 plus 20 will be 30. So AB, this distance will be 30. And now coming to this BC, how can we calculate BC? We know this total distance is 70. Is it or not? This total distance is 70. So when this total distance is going to be 70, but we just need only this part of the total distance, just this part, right? So only till this portion, this part alone we need to find, for which let's just think of what can be done. We know the total distance is 70. If we come to know this portion, we can very easily predict what would be the remaining distance. Is it or not? Now come to the vertical portion. How long this person is traveling in the vertical direction? Here we have a 20, and here again we have a 10. So 20 plus 10 would be 30. Is it or not? Yeah, fine. Because see here, there's a 20 here, he's moving up, and there's one more 10 here, he's moving up. So 20 plus 10 would be 30. So that means this total vertical distance is going to be 30. And now we can very easily tell the remaining portion. So out of this total 70, if 30 is subtracted here, this portion, I mean this BC will be 40, right? So that means in our Pythagoras theorem, this triangle, right angle triangle, we got the value of A to be equal to 30 and B to be equal to 40. Now all we need to do is we need to find the value of the C. Let's try to calculate it. C square is equal to A square plus B square, right? So A square will be none other than 30 square plus B square will be 40 square. Let's continue this. So C square will be equal to, this would be 900 plus 40 square. This would be 1600. So now when we come to add these two values, we'll be getting double zeros, and 9 plus 16 would give us 25. So that means 2500. So C square is 2500. It's very easy for us to say C will be nothing but, so just take the square root of 2500. We can easily say square root of 25 would be 5. Is it or not? That is, we know that 5 square is 25, and we have a double zero. That means double zero is nothing but, it's like 100. So that means when we insert one more zero, we can get it to be 50. So that means C value will be 50. That is, when we square 50 into 50, if we do, we'll get this value 2500. So that means if C square is 2500, C will be just 50. That's it, right? So that means the distance between the starting point and the ending point, or the answer to this question, will be 50 meters, which is matching with option 1. Yeah, fine. So we just had only one question for this session, and that too, it's going to be a very familiar question. We have solved it many times. These kind of questions we have solved in many times, we have solved in our previous sessions itself. So one such question is what we got for this session. I hope you are able to understand this, and any doubts you can post it in the comments. Again, in the next session, we'll catch up with some other set of questions. Thank you. Bye.